This is Serena Fox at Bloodstock 2022. I'm here for Total Rock, and I'm here with Cyhra. Yeah. And introduce yourself.
Yeah, I'm Alex Lennonberg, the drummer for Cyhra. I also play in a band called Kamelot. And yeah, I'm extremely happy to be here.
Fantastic. Well, thank you for coming along. You just come off stage.
Yes.
How was it?
That's great, actually. It's so much fun. I mean, obviously, you know, after these 2 years of not playing a whole lot, or actually not playing at all, any show is extremely special. And and coming back to the UK, also, I love the UK, I have to say. Great. I've lived in England up until the pandemic.
Really? Yeah. And then you moved back?
I moved back to Germany, which it was supposed to be temporarily, and then pandemic, Brexit, all these things happened.
Brexit.
Which made it kind of hard for me to come back, but, you know, never say never.
Well, I can't believe that you wouldn't. Well, surely you would be considered talent anyway. We don't need to debate the ins and outs of Brexit law. That would be a bit dull today, especially when we've got so much more to talk about.
Nicer topics than politics, that's for sure.
Exactly. Yes. Well, speaking of travel, you've been touring a lot.
Yes.
You got back from Japan just recently, is that right?
Well, not recently. We are going to go to Japan in January. Yes.
January.
Yes.
That's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
So you're going to be touring on the sort of Asian peninsula and that sort of thing?
Yeah, actually it's just going to be Japan, but quite extensively. I think 10 to 12 shows or something, which is quite a lot for Japan, because many times you just go there and you play two shows, like, whatever, Tokyo and Osaka or something.
Yeah.
But that's going to be like an extensive Japan tour. I guess I'm really looking forward to that.
Yeah, that should be incredible. You've been there before?
Yes, I've been there before, yes.
Oh, yeah. Always meaning to go and never actually.
You should, absolutely.
Maybe come and see you guys. Full year.
Excellent reason, that's for sure.
Yes. Well, you just mentioned earlier as well that you're in Kamelot.
Yes.
And all of the guys in your band have previous, In Flames and Amaranth.
Exactly.
Annihilator, all this sort of thing.
That was for me, actually.
Yes, I know.
Because I'm the drummer. So we always have like a ton of bands, drummers.
It kind of essentially makes you guys a super group, but what makes this different? What is this, a passion project?
That's the thing, it is, right? Because, of course, like this super group thing, I don't really believe in name dropping anymore or anything like that, you know. Like, and people, especially, they don't want to see or hear projects.
No.
So, and really, in our case, it's a band, and we really, you know, we became such good friends, and it's such a, and that's like that's at the heart of it. Like, it's the friendship and the fun that we have together. And the band is doing well, but at this point, it's not about that anymore. Not at least not exclusively.
Yeah.
And I think it's special in this regard. And of course, it's special because we are all bringing in our influences.
Yeah.
And by doing so, we're kind of creating this hopefully unique sound.
I can definitely hear shades of all of your previous projects coming together. But there is definitely a fresh new vibe to it.
Because I think the combination is new.
Yeah.
And wouldn't it be weird if you wouldn't be able to hear those things?
No,
like, you know, so it's kind of obvious, right? But
it feels like, you know, it's almost like you can see flavors on a plate, and I can hear that in music, and when it comes together, it tastes different.
Yes, exactly.
You know?
Yeah.
And that's what I really liked about your sound. It's also very, got, you know, a lot of classic metal vibes in there, but I also hear some poppy influences in there as well.
Of course, and it's a Scandinavian thing. It's the ABBA thing.
Yeah.
Like, I think they're born with that. It's like in their mother's milk. Really, when we're writing songs together, you can just tell that it just, you know, it has to be, you know, there has to be a hook, and it has to be sort of that pop thing.
Yeah, I mean,
they just can't avoid it.
I know, but it's
but
perfect.
It's great. I know,
perfect.
And I love it.
It gives it a real positive energy to it. You know, you've got the deep filth parts with your metal slapped on top is the pop sugar, and I love it. I think it sounds great.
Of course, that's what you know makes it so different from, for example, from a band like In Flames, I guess. Which maybe in the beginning, like, a lot of people expected us to sound more like that because of, you know, our guitarist or a bass player. But then again, it's all about being unique. It would have not made sense to be sort of an In Flames copy for us.
Yeah.
Like, that was never the point.
Well, I mean, I can definitely hear In Flames in there.
Oh, sure, of course,
Again, it's one of the flavors. It's not the top there. It's not the kids. It's its own unique sound, which I think is really cool.
Thank you. Let's hear that.
I wanted to ask about your coffee.
Yes.
Please tell me why you decided to start making coffee.
Okay, so, well, first of all, funny that you asked me, because I'm like the coffee drinker in the band.
Yeah.
I'm like a complete addict. It's actually quite the miracle that this is not coffee. But it's just because it was just water. And I was like, I was really disappointed.
I know.
But you're
never going to get good coffee here, let's be honest.
No, I think it's obviously tea is the thing here.
Yes.
And I appreciate that. But yeah, so I'm the coffee guy. And what happened is that this Swedish coffee company, Morgan, they approached the band actually and said, hey, would you like guys be up for having your own coffee? And we were like, sure, if we can really have a word and we can really try out the beans and try flavors and all that. And most importantly, they're it's an extremely fair company, like fair trade, yes. And they're working with specific farmers and paying them really well. The coffee is a little bit on the expensive side because of that. But
good coffee is expensive.
Yes, and especially fair trade, like the money really goes to these farmers, so we felt comfortable supporting that.
So you blended, you picked the blend yourselves.
Yes, we're able to pick the blends ourselves. Yeah, of course they were helping. Like we're not as much as I love coffee. I'm not an expert, right? They were helping with that. But it's incredible. It's just it's so nice to have your own coffee. It's like. Very special.
Wouldn't mind my own coffee, to be honest. Can you can get it online, is that right?
Yes, you can order it online.
Yeah.
And I encourage people to do it because it's also, like I said,
I do love coffee.
And it's a good thing. You're doing a good thing. Yeah.
Well, you can't, if it helps everybody, why not get it? Get coffee. Buy the coffee.
Buy the coffee, yes.
So, your last album was in 2019.
Yes.
Are you planning a new one?
Yes. We're actually recording the new album right now.
Right.
I think it's supposed to come out January, February. I'm not actually 100% sure, to be honest. We're releasing the first single will come out in August now.
August.
Yeah.
So the end of this month.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. And so at least I think it'll drop. Maybe September. No, I think end of August.
End of August. Okay.
And so we're recording it right now, and I mean. To be completely honest, we were extremely disappointed with the last album just being crushed by the pandemic. But of course, it happened to so many others as well.
Absolutely.
But we were so convinced that it's a great record and everybody loved it. And we felt like we had a great momentum with it.
Yeah,
we just started touring on it. And I think it's a great record. And it kind of died a little bit, on its ass, basically, because of the pandemic.
Have you been able to tour it now?
Yeah, sure. So we're able to support it. And of course, we can always play the songs and we can, feature it that way. But it is what it is. And we're doing the third record now. But the nice thing about the third record is we are recording a lot of the stuff a little more ourselves. And that was kind of because of the pandemic in the beginning. Originally, that was the thing to do, that we were like, okay, maybe it's easier for me to record in Germany, so there's no travel restrictions, so there might not be a problem with me going to Sweden and stuff like that. But it ended in a fresher approach, maybe, and a little more rock and roll.
Nice.
Because before, I think it was maybe a bit more polished, and this one is a bit more on the Van Halen side of things.
Nice.
And I think it's really good because the music already is so mainstream in a way.
Yeah.
So to then having the production be too polished, I think, is not nice. So it's really cool to kind of counterbalance that a bit with a more rock attitude.
Make it raw.
Yeah, make it raw, exactly.
Love it.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time, especially after you just come on stage to talk to us.
Thank you for having me.
It's been an absolute pleasure.
Same here.
Great to meet you.
Same here.
All the best.
Thank you.